So today we've been joined by Trinidad and Tobago's latest overseas-based signing, women's player Victoria Swift. Victoria, as you would have seen in the last week or so, signed a new deal with Mexican club Leon, and they play in the women's Premier Division of the Mexican Football League. Obviously, it's a major accomplishment for her because research has shown us that she's the first Trinidad and Tobago women's player to sign with a professional club in Mexican football. Of course, we've had players on the men's side dating back to the 60s and 70s who would have signed professionally in Mexico, but Victoria now has made history and she's hopefully now going to open doors for more of our women's players who are aspiring to take their careers further in the game. Victoria, welcome and thank you for taking this time to join us today.
Thank you for having me. It's a pleasure being here.
Okay, so I can see the excitement and the smile on your face. You're glowing, obviously, because this is a massive move in your career. Clearly, it must be also a testing period because moving to a new environment, a new country, new culture, what's it been like for you over the last 48 hours or so?
So I've actually been here in Mexico since August 1st.
Right.
So I actually had the opportunity to adapt to like the food and stuff. I think the hardest part was the altitude. So like my body is still adapting to like the high altitude aspect of it. So like usually like I love tacos. So coming to Mexico, it was awesome just because being able to eat tacos like basically anytime I want to, but then like I also had to, you know, switch from eating the tacos constantly to starting to cook my own meals. Simply because I want to be able to get the best nutrition to be able to perform on the field. So just like I had to switch from, you know, like the first couple of days was like tacos, and like now it's just basically me cooking my own meal to make sure that I get the best out of my body, like when I play and stuff.
And of course, I'm pretty sure the backroom staff, the medical staff at your club would also want you to follow a specific diet because now you're playing professional football. It's not no longer a question of just being in college back in the States and possibly being able to, you know, do as you please. What's it been like settling into that environment and now life as a professional player in Mexico?
So basically, when I came to Club Leon, it has like portions of they were welcoming. So it wasn't really difficult for me in order to settle in this environment. I would say that the only thing that was a bit challenging was like training and stuff, in the sense of we would train sometimes 7 a.m. in the morning, and then right after training straight into gym. So I can remember like with the whole COVID situation, like football in Trinidad like basically stopped, so like we didn't have the opportunity to like train or play. But that is something that I had made known to them before signing the contract. So they were well aware that, you know, like I haven't played in a while, and they were like, don't worry about that, still come, we work with you in terms of fitness, in terms of like strength and conditioning. So I'd say like the first week or so, like my body basically went into shock.
Yeah.
Just going from not really training as much or like training at a high intensity to jumping straight into like an environment where they train very hard, they train on a consistent basis. So it was like a bit difficult on my body for like the first couple of weeks that I was here.
Okay. Let me ask you though, if you're able to tell us, how did this all come about, especially knowing the fact that you have not been playing competitively for some months now? Obviously we know, and they would have seen you played for the national team, and they would have been following your exploits on the field of play. But how did this come about?
Basically, I went to the University of West Florida, so like I finished up my last 2 years there. And the goalkeeper there, she's actually Mexican-American. And she actually plays in the league in Mexico. So she just reached out to me and she's like, you know, like, hey, what are you doing? I said, I'm home, not doing anything because there's nothing to do. She said, like, you know, come play in Mexico. So I was like, okay, like, no problem. Like, you know, you could talk to the team and we'd see what they say. So basically, like, she reached out to the recruiter of the team. So actually, like, my journey coming here, it's supposed to be, she actually plays with Pachuca. And I actually went to Pachuca first.
Right.
And I was there for like a couple of weeks. But basically, I had damaged my knee playing like a couple years ago, and the medical staff, they just decided to do an MRI just to make sure everything was okay. And basically with them doing that, they thought that, they said like, you know, there's a lot to do, 6 to 8 weeks of rehab, but no surgery is required. So like, that was good news.
Right.
And then Club Leon basically said like, you know, like we, cause they saw me like training and put you and stuff. So like they said, we want her, we're going to do the rehab, we're going to pay her, we're going to sign her. So I was like, this is definitely an opportunity from God, because no team is normally going to take a player that has to do rehab, sign, pay, go on like full contract. So like I knew that that was definitely like my blessing in disguise. And when I like move across to Leon, the staff was very welcoming, players was very welcoming. Like I felt basically at home. The rehab here has been very difficult in the sense, like sometimes I wish I was playing. So like a training day for me would have been, so like I do still train with the team. So like technical work I do at first. Then I go out our rehab in the gym with my trainer, who is no mercy. I would be dying and she's like, you dress when you're done. So it's like, and then after that, it's like straight into like a really hard gym session with the team. So like my it's just been go. So like that's where the opportunity arose. And it's just like I definitely knew that it is God and he has me here for a reason. It's bigger than me. So like, I'm really excited. Not only to play, but just to be here to see what, like, you know, God has in store for me.
I'm listening to you and hearing you talk about your routine, and I'm so excited. So I could just imagine that our men's national coach, James Thomas, if he's looking on at this interview later, he's probably going to be just as excited knowing that one of his coaches is now, you know, going through such a regime, and because this will also prepare you for international football. Tell me something, at the club, are you the only Caribbean player or overseas-based player at that club, or what's the composition like?
So, it's myself and the other international players, actually, Martha Cox from Panama. She's actually the captain for Panama's national team. So she and I are the both internationals, because they're only allowed two internationals. So it's just she and I, the two internationals here. They have like a couple of players who are from America but has Mexican roots. Mm-hmm. And then they have players who are just Mexicans. So it's like a kind of a color.
Right. And I'm sure they must be excited to have somebody like you in that setup as well. Because again, as I mentioned earlier, would have been the first time that a Trinidad and Tobago women's player is in that environment, in that setup. Mm-hmm. What's the language barrier like? Do you speak Spanish, and how are you adapting to that?
So I actually don't. I'm actually now learning how to speak Spanish. At first, so like when I was at Pachuca, most of the, like there are a couple of players who still do speak English. The coach here didn't speak English, so like there was always like that barrier there. So sometimes like they would explain something in Spanish and they would just like go about and I'm like, hello, like,
yes,
I'm here. So then, you know, like when it was, I came to Leon, the coach, she just said like, you know, like she actually apologized to me about not being able to speak proper English. And she said like, you know, like I'm willing to learn, like I'm willing to take classes to learn to speak English. And then I have a couple of teammates here that also speaks English, but then me and myself, like I am actually trying to learn Spanish and communicate with my teammates like on and off the field. So like I would try to like, you know, have conversations with them in Spanish. And so like the coach, like during training, like she would teach me like phrases to say in Spanish like on the field. But basically because like communication on the field is one of my strong suits, it's like one of my strong points.
Right.
But because I can't speak the language, I wouldn't be able to communicate because I wouldn't know how to. So like it's been getting a lot better. And like I actually in training tried to speak in Spanish. So that way, like when it is like I do start playing with the team, like it won't be as difficult in order to like take instructions or understand what I'm saying.
Right, I get you. Tell us about the facilities there. Obviously, you know, Club Leon, they're known as one of the top teams in Mexico. So the facilities there must be second to none. How are you enjoying that, you know, that whole environment?
Now, the facilities here are actually really nice. They actually, because I've learned that in Mexico, what they are requiring from most of the professional teams is that they they build like a school and dorms and have fields for like U17, U15, U20 players. So they're training, they're going to school, like they're playing. And the mere fact of like, we don't have that in Trinidad, and seeing that in Mexico is just like amazing to see. And it's something that I hope in the future that Trinidad adapts, in the sense of like, you know, building a facility where players could go to school and then they train right here, so that they have that opportunity to get better right at home instead of having to leave home to get better. But the facilities here, there, it's really nice, and it's just like the level of professionalism is really awesome.
So my next question would be, do you see yourself possibly being someone or in a sense opening doors for other children to be good players or players from the Caribbean? Based on what you're seeing on the ground there, is that an opportunity that's going to be possible in the future, you think?
Yeah, because they actually recently, because one of my teammates messaged me about the opportunity in Mexico. She said they just changed the rules. So like at a point in time, it was no internationals and they just changed the rules. And I think not only like with myself, but also with Marta, with the Mexicans seeing that we bring that physical presence, or like that different, that like what Lee has been missing, I think is definitely going to open a door for other Caribbean players to definitely come and play in Mexico, because there's lots of teams here. And I'm sure, like, you know, once it is like Marta and I do get on the field, we actually have that chemistry, like coaches would want players from the Caribbean when it is they see that we bring such like a zeal and like a presence to the league and stuff in Mexico. The league actually, it started, they played a couple of games. So right now, like, the coach is really excited for me to start to play. Marta just debuted like 2 games ago. Uh-huh. And she has already impacted the team already. So just raise the stakes higher for when it is I do start to play. But they're actually in there. I think they probably have maybe about 30 more games left.
Right.
But the thing about this league, it runs in 2 parts. So it's like July to December and then January to May. So it's kind of like all year round.
Right.
That they do play. So right now they're actually like in season, but they're still training hard in season.
Yeah, I can imagine. And are you able to divulge any information about your contract in terms of what is the length of duration you're going to be there?
So right now it's still December.
Uh-huh.
But how it is, they had organized the contract is a way that they would be able to extend it even before it ends.
Right.
And I could even wait till December to see, like, if it is like I'm really not comfortable here, I could have the opportunity to leave and go to another team. Okay. So they made it really flexible to where it's a win-win situation for me and also for the club as well.
So as you know, there is a rivalry obviously over the years between Trinidad and Tobago and Mexico, especially in the men's version of the game. And you would have seen what transpired at that World Cup 2021. Did you receive any sort of banter or any sort of conversations with your new teammates on arriving there? Because I'm sure they would be following the exploits of their counterparts as well. And they would have seen what happened in World Cup 2021. We were able to pull them to a draw. What's it like, you know, being in that environment with them now, seeing that you're from Trinidad and Tobago?
Well, for me, well, my experience has been the complete opposite to what happened in the Gold Cup. As I said, like, the coaches and the players were very welcoming. Even like since when the team had announced, you know, my signing a couple of days ago, actually like fans from Club Leon, like Mexican fans, flooded my Instagram, and it was just like, you know, welcoming messages and stuff, and like, you know, like, we're so excited to see you play and excited to see what you bring to the league, and they were like, you know, we hope you enjoy it here in Leon. So like for me, the experience has been really, really good since coming to Mexico.
Well, that's really good to hear, and I'm sure our men's counterparts, the men's team, will be anxious and excited for you and hoping to see that you're will prosper there in that league. And it's good to see that you're in an environment now where they're willing to aid your development, because this is going to be this is a massive development for our women's game as well. The fact that you're there now And my next question is going to be, how much are you looking forward to at some point rejoining the national setup here? Because we know we have a new coaching staff in place, and there are new matches coming up. The qualification for the next World Cup is going to be approaching as well. Do you see yourself wanting to be part of this whole setup and that whole initiative?
Yes, I do, and it's like I think that, like, I'm more excited of the mere fact that my training now in Mexico is at a high level, and I'm also training high altitude. So when it is, I do go to somewhere where the altitude is not as high, it's going to be a lot easier for me to play in such an environment. And I believe, like, it's also good for me in the sense of, like, working under different coaches, because it helps me build my resume as a player. So I'm excited that I'd be fit and ready going into a tournament rather than having to struggle with fitness or, like, injuries and stuff like that. So, like, I'm really excited, you know, to be a part of the national team, because I haven't been there in a while. Just like with the mere fact I was just focused on school and graduating, I didn't want to mess up my grades because of travel and stuff like that. So I made the personal decision in order to stay in school and to graduate with honors, which I did. So
tell us a bit more about that in terms of you know, that whole process and being able to balance the books and the football, and now you're an accomplished graduate. Tell us about that.
Basically, in college, so, like, I went to a junior college, so I went to Navarro College at first, and then I finished off my 2 years at the University of West Florida. And it so happened that both coaches from both institutions are very strict when it comes to grades. So it's like, if it is you don't pass, you could either lose your scholarship or you don't play. And they had it in such a way that they, like, even when it is we had away games, that we would have study hall, either in the bus, either in the hotel. So, like, we never really missed much in school. And so, like, in junior college, I actually wasn't trying to graduate with honors, but I did. And when it is I got to the University of West Florida, I made it my own goal to graduate with honors again. So there were a lot of late nights, early mornings with training. And obviously there had to be, like, a lot of sacrifice. So it's just like, as a student athlete, you can't do things that a normal student do who isn't into sports. So, you know, it's just about having that discipline, not only on the field, but also off the field. And, you know, at both schools, I was the team captain. So, like, I obviously had to lead by example. So, like, I couldn't tell a player, you have to pass your classes and, like, you know, play well if it is I wasn't doing it.
Right.
So, like, me being in that leadership role, like, I had to, you know, lead by example. So, like, I basically passed all my classes, performed well on the team, and it, like, it was just like, I think that experience shaped me and molded me even more to go into the professional level of it, in the sense of having that balance and having that discipline, especially during season. So for me, it worked out pretty well.
And what was your area of study?
I did sports management.
All right, excellent. So at some point, once you're finished playing, we can see you coming back into Trinidad and Tobago football to contribute in a meaningful way. Tell me about your family, especially your mom. We're very familiar with your mom at the FA as well, and your other sisters. They must be so happy for you and so excited. What's it been like, you know, you being away from home? But I'm sure they're going to be looking on and looking at all the live streams to see when they can catch a glimpse of you on the field of play.
So, like, honestly, me leaving Trinidad was kind of abrupt. So, like, I had a meeting with the team, like, on a Wednesday and a Friday, and then I left the following Monday to come to Mexico. So just kind of like a hassle to get everything, like, in order. My mom was a bit worried with, like, the whole COVID situation and stuff like that. My sisters were really excited because they knew that I've been home for a while, and, like, you know, like, I wanted to get back into playing and stuff like that. So they're excited, you know, to see me start back playing and stuff like that.
All right, that's perfect to hear. Well, Victoria, we want to wish you the best and thank you for this time. This was really meaningful and I think very educational as well, for especially the younger players who are, you know, looking up to somebody like yourself. Maybe you can leave us with a note for some of these players, especially the women's players in Trinidad and Tobago. There's been nothing happening domestically from a playing standpoint. And we know the women's team is back on the field of play right now in terms of training and preparing for what's to come. But what would you say to some of these players who are looking for an opportunity similar to what you've been able to get and what you've been able to take with open arms?
though, like, I would just say to them, like, I know, like, with the whole COVID situation and the level of uncertainty, it may, like, for some players, it may be daunting in the sense of, like, I don't know if I'll get the opportunity to go and play. Like, should I still train? Should I not? So it's just about, you know, staying prepared and finding that motivation within yourself in order to continue training and to continue playing. Because if it is, you do get called up, you don't want to go to an opportunity unfit or not prepared. Because if it is, you do that, you don't only make things bad for yourself, but you make things bad for those who may want that opportunity after you. So it's just about finding that central point of being motivated and, you know, continue working hard, because the opportunities are going to come, but it's just for us to be ready. And I think that's something that we struggle with, in the sense of, like, we would see that opportunities are not happening, so we won't stay ready. So when it is a sign, you know, to do go and play, we're never ready or we're never prepared. So it's just about always being ready and always staying prepared, regardless of if it is we have a coach or not, or regardless of the situation with the federation and stuff like that. You personally have to be prepared. And I think, like, doors are going to be open, because the more players are going out, coaches are going to be looking in Trinidad for players, because it happened with me in college. Like, my junior college coach has been looking in Trinidad for players, just because I went there and I made a good name for Trinidad and Tobago. So it's always about, you know, being prepared. And if it is, like, my coach would ask me about a player, if it is that player is prepared to go, I would say, like, yes, you could take that player. So it's just about opening doors for other players and not just thinking about yourself.
Excellent. Have you had a conversation with our head coach, James, in terms of what are his plans, and how it's going to work out with you now being away from home and possibly coming back into the setup, national setup, at some point later this year?
So, actually, when James first came to Trinidad, I was able to meet him in person and have, like, discussions with him. And I also, like, we still text from time to time, because, like, he always checks up on me to see how I'm doing. The only thing that I'm not sure of right now is that, like, you know, when it is they do have, like, the camps and the tournament later on this year, how it is the coach here would react to me leaving. Yeah. So, like, that is still up in the air. But James and I have been, like, communicating on a regular basis. So my name is Victoria Swift. I'm 26 years of age. I'm from Freeport, Trinidad. Big up to my central people. I am actually currently playing in Club Leon, and one of the biggest things that in my life I think a lot of people don't know about me is that Christ is the center of my life, and, you know, me giving my life to him has been the best decision ever. And since I did that, it's just been blessings after blessings after blessings. So it's just made me more excited about not only life, but also football as well. And it's just been a journey that I'm excited to go on and just open doors for more players after me.
All right, Victoria, we want to thank you for this time. It was a wonderful opportunity, a great spending time with you. We're going to be rooting for you. We're going to be following you. And we want to take this opportunity to wish you the very best going forward, and good luck on the field of play out there.
Okay, thank you so much.